What is an adventure?
Well, according to the dictionary, an adventure is a risky undertaking or an exciting experience. But what makes a great adventure? And what drives us to even want to go on one in the first place? Well, those questions will be answered. But like any great adventure, this story starts out unexpectedly. When this woman named Molly, who just so happens to run one of the best rafting companies in the country, wanted to help me answer that age-old question.
All right, so we are all packed up and ready to go. We are going to hit the Colorado River for the next 4 days. I'm terrified right now. I have never been camping. I've never been whitewater rafting, and we're doing it in literally some of the biggest rapids in the entire country.
We're going off the road!
And I've never even slept in a sleeping bag. The plan is we are going to head to Mile to Wild, who is making this whole thing happen. And I guess we are taking a jet boat to meet our rafting guides, wherever they might be on the river. This adventure is starting right now.
I guess we'll be meeting up with our rafting guides in about an hour and a half. I'm nervous as all heck. This is what it's about, right?
So we have officially made it to our campsite. They're getting everything packed up, and then we will be heading out on the river. Just had some breakfast, drinking a cup of joe. I am still terrified and nervous. Our guides seem super informative and cool that they do everything. They freaking make your food, they do your dishes, they pack up the campsite. It is really an all-inclusive trip when you're coming out here, but you're still in the wild. You're still experiencing something that you read in a freaking storybook. I mean, this is gonna be fun.
Now, after leaving camp, our first adventure of the trip would take us to a trail that ancient Native Americans have walked for thousands of years. This would only be the tiniest taste of what's to come.
We made it.
Petroglyphs were 1,000 years old. This trail that we are hiking, these Pueblo Native Americans were hiking the same trail 1,000 years ago. Probably these same exact rocks. Incredible. The fact that these people were in here that long ago is so cool. Mild the wild. This place knows what they're doing. It is quite wild out here. And after hiking, it was finally time to enter Cataract Canyon, home for the foreseeable future. The danger signs weren't encouraging, and not knowing it at the time, this group on the shore would be the last humans we'd see for our entire trip. This was starting to become the real adventure I'd always hoped it'd be. But before heading on further, we'd stop for lunch as a group, go swimming.
Times like this is best to not think.
Before having to take on the first rapid of the trip if we wanted to make it to camp for the night. From where we are like a half a mile away from these rapids, and you can literally hear them. So that danger sign was not joking around. Terrified right now, but I'm just looking forward to making it through the rapids, hanging out at camp, and just chilling tonight. Because I am terrified. Let's go see what the first rapids of the trip has in store. Let's go.
If you grab a hold of that, you're not gonna go anywhere else. We can pull you back in. The way we pull people back in, most likely they're gonna be reaching out with their hand. Don't grab the hand, right? Because if you grab somebody's arm, they get twisted and pulled around under the boat. Very easily dislocate a shoulder. That way I've seen it happen.
But fortunately for us, the only rapid we'd face on day one would be the smallest we'd encounter the entire trip. And having made it past rapid number one, the adventure would now present a brand new challenge. Camping in the middle of nowhere. Quite the daunting task when one's never even slept in a tent before.
We are at camp and we get to choose any spot we want to camp at for the night. I'll show you the spot that I decided to pick. Let me know if I picked a good spot.
So with a little help from our new friend Herb, we had a home. And it might seem ridiculous, but he helped me overcome something I never thought I was cut out for. And it helped me realize I was capable of taking on this adventure.
I think we might have home for the night. Now it is time to eat, to drink, to play games, and to relax. I am fried like a lobster right now. Make this cozy for the night, and wake up and do it again tomorrow. What a catch.
That is cooking, I'll be ready in probably 45 minutes. Yeah.
Good morning from day two. I'm waking up with energy. I'm waking up ready to go. I'm waking up excited. I feel like Indiana Jones right now. I'm living in my own storybook movie. I have read books about these great adventurers going on these great adventures to faraway places and doing crazy things. And ever since reading those books, it has just made me fascinated with the idea of getting out here and doing it on my own without tour companies like Mile to Wild. This is impossible. If a guy like me comes out here solo, he's dead. He's gone. He's fish bait. Throw me in the river. One day I will look back and tell my kids about this when their grandpa kayaked 100 miles down that river. And he was no outdoorsman.
But before we rafted down river, a day in which we'd encounter 10 different rapids, our first adventure was to hike up to a famously remote outlook on top of a desolate mountain known as the Dollhouse, supposedly the best views of our entire journey. And after a very steep hike to the top, we were now in one of the most remote locations in the country, which then led us to a cave, once inhabited by Native Americans, through a narrow cavern, to the best outlook of the canyon we'd ever see. And as we made our way down, it was time to say goodbye to camp, head down the river, and find a new place to call home. But first, we'd have to get a better taste of some of these rapids.
We are going to be trying a very dangerous tactic. We are essentially duct taping the GoPro to the back of the kayak in hopes of getting a good view. If it doesn't work, the whole trip is essentially over.
Knowing it at the time, these would pale in comparison to what would be faced tomorrow. We were on the cusp of entering the most aggressive section of the canyon. But first, we'd stop and pitch camp for the night before the most intense day of rafting most of our group has ever experienced.
The waves that you saw us hitting right then were 3.5. So tomorrow, the smallest one we're going to be hitting are 4s. So you could obviously see why that is terrifying. I mean, the rush you get on those waves when you're going up and down, whoa, you know, it is just it's an adrenaline rush like nothing I've ever really felt before. I was thinking we're gonna set up camp right here, and this will be our view for the night.
Day two has kicked my butt, but I'll tell you what, the view from the tent, not bad.
So after a long day, it was time to eat dinner and get sleep before the biggest day of the adventure.
Morning from day three on the Colorado. Last night, it was pretty hard to get sleep. I had some pretty gnarly nightmares, and I think there's just a lot of nerves going into today. Today is really kind of the climax of everything that we've been waiting for these last 2 days. Let's go.
It was time for one last look at camp and a good breakfast before we set out for a day that wouldn't be soon forgotten.
It is officially time for us to hit the river. These nerves are at an all-time high right now. I mean, we are so far out here. It makes you realize the seriousness of the situation. If something goes wrong, there's no going to a hospital. I mean, it would have to be a full-on extraction out of here by helicopter. I'm hoping that by the end of this, I proved to be a little bit more capable than I thought I was coming into this. I have some stories to tell, and I have a very memorable experience. Let's do this. But these were just preparing us for the three biggest rapids, known as Big Drop 1, 2, and 3. So big, we had to get out and plan our path, because if it didn't go perfectly, the entire boat is bound to flip. This was quite literally the moment we'd all come here for.
Big Drop 1.
After getting through the most dangerous part, fear left us, and it was time to have a little fun. Calming down from all the adrenaline, it was time for a much needed lunch. We did it. We made it through the biggest pockets of rapids. This has probably been the most memorable 3 days of my life. What a freaking adventure. Molly, you know how to set up adventures. Everything has went perfectly so far. And things would continue to go perfectly as we finished our lunch and made our way to the last campsite of the trip. I even learned how to set up my own tent.
The final supper.
The track.
It's hard to like think back on the last few days. It feels so long and so short at the same time. This is what I think an adventure is. I think an adventure is trying to create an unforgettable memory. And adventures can be scary, terrifying. And a lot of the times that the fear is gonna hold us back from actually going on and taking on the adventure head on. You do decide to take on the adventure. A lot of times you do come away with, especially if the adventure is terrifying, you come away with a memory that is, it's not gonna be forgotten anytime soon. And it might show you that you're a lot more capable than you thought you were. If you're craving a memory, that's something that is calling to you. Go and create that memory, because that's what life is. It's a string of memories and stories to tell. And this was one pretty cool story to tell. So like any good adventure, our story wouldn't be complete without a fitting ending. Coming into the canyon on jet boat would look pretty easy compared to how we'd have to get out. Colorado. Thanks for watching. See you guys next time.
And I just wanted to give one last thank you to Molly and Mild the Wild for making this whole thing happen. They didn't pay me to say this, but it was truly one of the best 4 days of my life. And if you ever are considering going on an adventure, I highly suggest you book with Mild the Wild. Their link is going to be in the description below. They will take care of you. They will give you one of the best experiences that I think you can possibly have. I'll see you guys soon.